Hello dear students, today we are going to study the salt analysis. So without wasting time, let us start studying about the salt analysis. The aim for today's practical is to analyze the given salt for acidic and basic radical. Acidic radical, that is anion, and basic radical, that is cation. We generally follow this pattern that we understand the experiment, we observe the result of the experiment, and then we come to a conclusion. That conclusion, we consider it as an inference. Today, the salt which is given to us is this salt that we have. You can see the salt. It is a solid salt, a crystalline salt, blue in color, and this is the kind of salt which we are going to analyze today. So let us analyze the salt for the various tests. You have seen the physical state. The physical state is solid. So FeCl3 and other semi-solid salts are absent. Color of the salt. The salt is blue colored salt, and we can say that Cu+2 may be present. When we smell this salt, there is no specific smell. So the ions which gives the specific smells, for example, NH4+ ion, ammonium ion, or CH3COO-, acetate ions may be absent. Now, my dear students, we are going to study the various heating tests for the salt. The first test that we are going to study is the dry heating test for this salt. In this experiment, we heat the salt into the dry test tube. So let us see what happens when we heat the salt into the dry test tube. You can see that I have a blank or a vacant test tube in which I'm going to add the salt. The salt is now added to the test tube. You can see the blue color salt at the bottom of the test tube. With the test tube holder, we have hold the test tube, and now we are going to heat this salt on the test tube. Let us see what happens to the salt. You can see that a blue color salt is present in the test tube. Now we are going to heat it. You can observe it well from the test tube itself. The salt is heated. You can see the salt is being heated slowly in the test tube. Now you might have observed the white color at the bottom of the test tube. The blue color slowly vanishes and the salt turns white in color from the 90 angle. Even you can definitely see the white bottom, but the upper part is yet blue in color. Now you can see easily that the salt is completely white at the bottom. That blue color salt has simply turned out to be white in color now. So the blue color salt on heating turns out white in color. You can observe it well. Let us observe the mouth of the test tube and see what you can find there. You can see there are lots of water droplets collected over here at the mouth of the test tube. You can see these water droplets easily. When we have taken the test tube, there were no water available, but now you can see the water droplets collected at the mouth of the test tube. You can observe it well, those water droplets. Yes, you can see it now very clearly, the various water droplets collected at the mouth of the test tube. So when we heat the given salt, we can observe that the blue color of the salt vanishes, it goes away, and the salt turns white in color. This white color salt also produces the water droplets, and these water droplets are collected at the mouth of the test tube. This is how, my dear students, you can easily understand it. You can see the salt lying here. Now we have this water. We have water with us. We are going to add water to the white color salt. So I shall use, I'm going to add water drop by drop to the white color salt. You can see the first drop has entered, and you can see the white color salt turns into blue color. You can easily see that the white color salt has completely turned into blue color by the addition of the droplets of water. So again, when we add the water, again when we add the water to the white salt, the salt simply turns into blue color. So this is what we can easily understand and observe. So we have seen the dry heating test. In dry heating test, heat the given salt in the dry test tube. What we observe is salt turns white. The salt simply turns white in color. The water droplets are formed on the mouth of the test tube, and when we add water in it, it turns blue. There is no specific smell gas is produced during this experiment. And this is what it is, the characteristics of copper 2 sulfate. So we can assume that we have copper 2 sulfate may be present as a given salt. But those salts which give the various smells, like those ions which gives the various smells, like the smell of ammonia or the pungent smell of nitrogen dioxide or the greenish yellow glass chlorine with the pungent smell, they should be absent. That is what we can conclude here. When we mix the salt with solid sodium hydroxide and heat it, there is no specific smell, and we can assume that the NH4 plus ion may be absent. Mix the salt with solid oxalic acid and heat it. When we mix the salt with the solid oxalic acid and heat it, we do not get any smell of vinegar, and that is how we can conclude that we have CH3COO- acetate ion may be absent. Now, my dear students, we have another important test, which is known as the flame test. A pinch of salt is allowed to burn in the oxidized flame, and let us see what happens when we perform the flame test, my dear students. So let us see the flame test. Let us go for the flame test, my dear students. Here we have a flame test to observe. You can see that we have a flame now. This is what it is known as the oxidized flame. We shall take the pinch of salt, and then we should allow it to burn it. You can see that this is the salt color, which is a blue in color. That is the given salt to us. And now we are going to allow it to burn into the oxidizing flame. And let us observe what happens. You can see that you have various colors of the flames produced, but let us wait and we may get the single color flame. Let us wait until we get the final single color. Now you can see, my dear students, that when we burn it, we get only green flame. This green flame suggests us the presence of, let us see, what does it suggest? And let us note it down. So when a pinch of salt is allowed to burn in the oxidizing flame, green colored flame is observed. And this green colored flame, iron such as Cu plus 2 may be present. That is what we can conclude. Now, my dear students, we are going to observe the VAT test. Generally, we perform this VAT test for the identification of the negative ions. First, we shall take the salt and add the dilute acid to it. We generally, in this particular salt, we do not get the effervescence, and that is how we can say that there is carbonate ion CO3 minus 2 absent. When we perform the MnO2 test, that means if we take the salt and add concentrated sulfuric acid and then add manganese dioxide MnO2, we use Cu foil as a catalyst here, and when we heat it, we do not get greenish yellow gas, and that is how we can conclude that Cl minus ion is absent in the salt. The next test that we are going to perform is the BaCl2 test. This test is also known as the barium chloride test. So, my dear students, let us perform the barium chloride test. Let us see the barium chloride test for the salt analysis. You can see here we have the solution of the given salt, which is blue in color. It is the aqueous solution. You can see it very well. This is the aqueous solution of the given salt to us. It's a blue in color. Now, my dear students, we have the another solution. This is the solution of the barium chloride. So this is a barium chloride solution that we have here with us. You can see the barium chloride solution. You can very well see the two different solutions now. Now this solution, we are going to mix them. And let us see what happens. Well, the reaction is not meaningful here before we perform the test, but still you can see that both the solutions, that we are going to mix them and see what happens. Sorry, this is the disturbance, unnecessary for us. Yes, let us see what happens when both the solution of the given salt and the barium chloride are mixed. When we mix both the solution, yes, you can see that slowly both the solution are mixed. You can see the precipitates are produced. These are the white precipitates. You can easily see it. Please have a look to it. we add drop wise some more salt solution, or we mix both the solution, and now you can see the precipitates which are formed. You can easily see the white precipitates which are formed, and you can understand the reaction well. So this is how, my dear students, when we add the salt solution, or when we mix the salt solution with the barium chloride solution, we generally get the white precipitates from it, and this is how we truly understand the reaction or the barium chloride test. So we have just performed the barium chloride test. We have taken the salt solution and barium chloride aqueous solution, and both these solution are being mixed. We have got the white precipitates. These white precipitates are generally insoluble in HCl. These white precipitates are generally insoluble in HCl, and that is how we confirm that we have SO4 minus 2 present, or not confirm, but at this level we will just say that SO4 minus 2 is present because of this test. We still have to perform the confirmatory test to get the confirmation for the sulfate ion. The next test is brown ring test. In an aqueous medium, we take salt and then we add the freshly prepared solution of FeSO4, and then slowly we add the concentrated sulfuric acid flowing, touching the wall of the test tube. At the juncture of these two solutions, the mixture of the salt and freshly prepared FeSO4 and the sulfuric acid, both the liquid are separated from each other, and at the juncture we do not get any brown colored ring. And as we do not get brown colored ring, we consider NO3 minus ion is absent. So from the above test, my dear students, we have just an idea that we have Cu plus 2 ion and SO4 minus 2 ion. They may be present into the salt. Let us do the group analysis for the salt so that we can come to know that what is the positive ion present into it, and we can be more sure about the presence of the salt or presence of the ion that we thought that we have. Let us go for the group analysis, or the analysis for copper 2 ion. So let us perform the various tests for the confirmation of the copper plus 2 ion that we have thought we may have it. So let us perform the analysis. What are the various materials that we need? We need a salt solution, we need dilute HCl, we need H2S gas, we need 50% HNO3, that is nitric acid, we need dilute sulfuric acid, we need distilled water, and we need alcohol. We even need ammonium hydroxide, which is also known as liquor ammonia, and we need a facility to heat the solution in the water bath. So we have all those facilities available with us. You can see here, this is the facility available for heating the solution into the water bath. So this is the beaker in which there is water present, and we heat using this device, this particular water, and then we put the test tube into it so that it can be heated. Now let us perform the test. First, we'll have to take the salt solution. Now we are going to add dilute HCl to it. So let us have a look at that. You can see, my dear students, when we add dilute HCl, there are no effervescences produced, and we can even say that CO3 minus 2 is absent. You can see HCl is added. Now we are going to pass the H2S gas from the mixture of the dilute HCl and the salt solution. My dear students, when we add the dilute HCl and we do not get any precipitates, we can say that group 1 is absent. Now, in the mixture of the solution of the given salt and the HCl, now we are going to pass the H2S gas. You can see that when we pass the H2S gas through the solution, we get black precipitates. Let us have a look to it once again. We are going to add dilute HCl. When we add it, there are no effervences. There is no precipitates formed by adding. Now we are going to pass H2S gas, and you can see that the precipitates, black precipitates, are formed. These black precipitates which are formed, you can see here those black precipitates easily. That is what we are going to divide them into the two parts. So here we have divided those black precipitates into two different parts. And now we are going to proceed further. In the next process, we'll take the one part of the solution that we have taken. See, my dear students, we have taken the first part of the solution. We have made those black precipitates into two parts, and into first part now we are going to add 50% HNO3. So let us add 50% HNO3 to the given or to the obtained black precipitates. 50% HNO3 into the black precipitates drop wise, and now we are going to heat it into the water bath. When we heat the black precipitates into the water bath with HNO3, we get the solution of copper nitrate, which is water soluble. And this is how the black precipitates are dissolved. And now you can see a solution which do not have the black precipitates. Now, my dear students, we are going to add dilute H2SO4 to that particular solution. Drop wise, you can see now we are going to add alcohol. You can see we have alcohol available with us. We are going to add alcohol to it. Drop wise, alcohol is added. Now we are going to add ammonium hydroxide solution to this mixture of, you can see the blue coloration. This blue coloration is because of this complex tetramine copper nitrate. And this tetramine copper nitrate, which is blue in color, and this is how, my dear students, we understand the various tests. So, my dear students, we can understand the various tests for the analysis. Let us have a look to something that we are going. See, first we want to go for the group analysis. So first we need to prepare the original solution. The original solution that we prepare by dissolving the salt into the distilled water looks like this. So this is the solution of the given salt which we have dissolved into the distilled water. So this is the blue color solution that we have when we dissolve the salt into the distilled water. This solution we call it as a original solution. As we are given the water soluble salt, we can say that original solution is the solution of the salt in the distilled water. Now this original solution is added dilute HCl. You have just seen the experiment. There were no precipitates, so group 1 is absent, where Ag plus Pb plus 2 and Hg plus 1 are absent. Then we have again the original solution. We add a dilute HCl aqueous solution, and then we pass the H2S gas. You can see that we had got a black precipitation, and that is why we may say that Cu plus 2 and Pb plus 2 may be present. Now again we perform heat the black precipitates with minimum quantity of 50% HNO3. We have added 50% HNO3 so that the precipitates get dissolved. Now add dilute sulfuric acid H2SO4 and need to add alcohol to the 1 power. When we add the dilute HNO3 when we have the 1 part of dissolved black precipitate solution in HNO3, and if we have dilute H2SO4 and alcohol, if there were no white precipitates, we may say that PB plus 2 is absent. Now in the same solution or the another part, 1 part of the dissolved black precipitate solution, now we add dilute H2SO4, we add alcohol, and then we add excess of ammonium hydroxide. We have seen that we got the blue coloration, and that is why we can say that Cu plus 2 is present. Now, my dear students, we need to divide this blue colored solution into 2 parts. So you have just seen that we had a blue color solution. That blue color solution has to be divided into 2 parts so that we can perform the various confirmative tests for Cu plus 2 ion. So let us study the confirmative test for the Cu plus 2 ion, my dear students. So let us have a look to the various tests which are the confirmative tests for Cu plus 2 ion. The first confirmatory test that we are going to study is known as the potassium ferrocyanide test. Let us have a look to the potassium ferrocyanide test. The various materials we need the 1 part of blue solution. In this we have acetic acid, potassium ferrocyanide. We have droppers. Let us perform the test. We take acetic acid with the help of the dropper and add it to the 1 part of the blue solution that we have obtained. You can see that the reaction takes place and the blue coloration is because of the formation of the CuSO4. Now we are going to add potassium ferrocyanide. You can see that we have got the chocolate brown colored precipitates. This chocolate brown colored precipitates is because of the complex formed by the reaction of the copper sulfate and potassium ferrocyanide. This chocolate brown colored precipitates gives us the confirmation that we have Cu plus 2 ion present into the salt. Now, my dear students, we are going to perform the another test, which is known as the potassium iodide test. The various materials required for this test are 1 part of the blue solution. We need acetic acid, we need potassium iodide, and we need the droppers. We take acetic acid and add it to the 1 part of the blue solution that we have obtained. You can see again that copper sulfate are produced. These copper sulfate are mainly responsible for the blue coloration. Then we are going to add potassium iodide to the solution. When we add potassium iodide solution, you can see that we have got the brown colored solution. We have got the brown colored solution. When we add it drop wise, my dear students, when we add it, we get precipitates, potassium iodide we are going to add. Here you can see that in a brown color solution, we have got white precipitates. These white precipitates are because of the copper iodide Cu2I2, and the solution turns brown because of the presence of the iodine into the solution. This test also confirms the presence of Cu plus 2 ion into the given salt, my dear students. So this is how, my dear students, we truly understand the confirmatory test for our Cu plus 2 ions. So this is what we have written. for the confirmation of Cu plus 2 ion, we have a potassium ferrocyanide test. To one part of the blue solution, add acetic acid solution and add the solution of potassium ferrocyanide. Chocolate brown precipitates are formed, which confirms the presence of Cu plus 2 ion. We have the next test, potassium iodide test. To one part of the blue solution, add acetic acid and the solution of potassium iodide. The white precipitates are formed in the brown solution, and again it confirms the presence of Cu plus 2 ion. Now, my dear students, we want to confirm the presence of sulfate ion, SO4 minus 2 ion. We have already seen the barium chloride test, and the another test that we are going to perform for the sulfate ion is our lead acetate test. So let us perform the various tests for us, my dear students. Let us perform the various tests for our solution. We have already seen the barium chloride test. Let us have a look to it once again, or let us move to the next test, which is known as the lead acetate test. You might have seen that in barium chloride test we had a white precipitates. Now let's look at the lead acetate test. So let us see the lead acetate test, my dear students. Here I have the blank test tube, in which I am going to take the blue color solution of the given salt. You can see the blue color solution of the given salt. I have the solution of the lead acetate, which is filled into this bottle. And I have one more solution. This solution is the solution of ammonium acetate that is there in the test tube. So we are going to perform this test. You can see that in a blank test tube, I'm adding, or we have a blue colored solution of the salt that is given to us. You can see blue colored solution of the salt. In this blue colored solution of the salt, now I'm going to add the lead acetate solution. So you can see that I'm going to add the lead acetate solution to the particular given salt solution. I'm going to add it drop wise. You can see here the reaction. Yes, when you add, or when you mix the given salt solution and lead acetate, you can easily see the reaction, and we have the white color generated into the test tube. Now, my dear students, if you really observe it, you will find the white precipitates are separated from the salt solution. So you will get two layers formed. One layer is the will be the layer of the white precipitates, and another layer would be the blue solution. Now you can easily see that two layers have been generated. First, the bottom layer is the layer of the white precipitates, and then you have the blue solution above it. You can easily see the white precipitates now. It is easy for you to observe the white precipitates produced at the bottom. We still have a blue coloration into the test tube, but you can easily observe the white precipitates in the test tube. Now I'm going to add the solution, which is the solution of the ammonium acetate. So we want to check out whether these white precipitates are soluble in ammonium acetate solution or not. In the another test tube, I have ammonium acetate solution. This ammonium acetate solution, I shall add it to the white precipitates, and you can see that slowly the white precipitates have been vanished. You cannot see any further white precipitates into the test tube. The white precipitates have been disappeared, and you can easily come to know that these white precipitates which were produced, they can be easily dissolved into the solution of the ammonium acetate. So this is how, my dear students, we again confirm the presence of the sulfate ions in the soil. So the confirmative test for acidic radical, and we may guess that we have SO4 minus 2 as the acidic radical or anion present into the soil. So we confirm the presence of the SO4 minus 2 by the barium chloride test and the lead acetate test. The barium chloride, even in the barium chloride test, we take the aqueous solution of salt and then we add aqueous barium chloride solution. This aqueous barium chloride solution, when we add, we get white precipitates which are insoluble in hydrochloric acid. So we can confirm the SO4 minus 2 ion. At the same time, when we have lead 2 acetate test, aqueous solution of salt and aqueous solution of lead 2 acetate, when they are allowed to react with each other, you might have seen that white precipitates are produced, and these white precipitates are soluble in excess of ammonium acetate solution. Generally, we use here the hot ammonium acetate solution, and you can confirm the presence of SO4 minus 2. So we can conclude, or we can write the result for the salt analysis, that we have basic radical Cu plus 2 and acidic radical SO4 minus 2. I hope, my dear students, you've enjoyed your studies. I wish you happy learning, my dear students. Happy learning.